And it's been a MAC game that's been circled on the calendars all year. Coldwater at Marion Local, both 6-0, both ranked number one in the state in their respective divisions by the AP. Both defending state champs, and the similarities do not end there. In fact, both coaches feel the two teams are so similar, the game will be decided by who can execute better and take advantage of opportunities. Perhaps that's why Marion Local was practicing for Coldwater's patented double pass play. Coach Goodwin's club always ready for action.
Streaks in the state of Ohio.
Hey, look, it's Patrick and Dan. They had the call of a good one tonight. Doc Rethman back to pass. The FCA leader hooks up with a lengthy Ryan Bruns, and he lunges forward to the five. Then the pitch midway through that first quarter to J.C. Gottemiller. He tucks in right behind his line. 7-0 Flyers midway through the first. Second quarter, same score at this point. They give to Gottemiller, great blocking ahead of him, and he gets a piece of the pile on another. Marion Local score, extra point, no good, so it's 13-0 Flyers. Coldwater looking to jumpstart that offense. Brody Hoyne over the middle, tipped into the hands of Gottemiller for the INT. JC, of course, playing both sides of the ball well tonight. Flyers take over, and Rethman looking for more. Gives it a heave, but Aaron Harlemert jumps up and gets a good position on the coverage. Cavs take over at their own 10. Hoyne trying to march them back. Passes to Harlemert on the screen, goes up the sideline, and as he goes to the 40 before being pushed out, but that play called back on a penalty. So Hoyne, the future Eastern Michigan defensive back, takes the snap, avoids the rush, finds Kyle McKibben making a diving catch at 31, but Marion Local pitches the shutout. Flyers get it. They move to 7-0. 20-0 is the victory.